Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genci and today we are going to talk about advanced floor settings. I'm going to use the same family that we had for the advanced wall series. I'm going to load it into project. I can close the family. And we have this building. We want to work on like surroundings of the building. If it helps to understand the building better, feel free to go with wall by face. And you can add some walls. You can also go with curtain walls and add some glass walls here. Okay, and then you can just hide the mass. So I'm interested to work on this side of the building. Maybe I can go through either level one or site. Let's assume that we are going to have one street over there. And we are going to work on the pavement on the sidewalk between the building and the street. I want to type TL to switch to thin lines. Then I would like to go to floor, architecture floor. I'm going to assume like about 3 meters of sidewalk. This is like a wide sidewalk here. And that side, maybe over there. Let's say maybe we have a little bit of space on the other side of the building. So this is going to be 3 meters away from here and 3 meters away from here. I want to trim the lines. Also, I want to pick some lines here with no offset. This is going to show us the other side of the pavement. We can later double check the lines in one section view. This seems about right. I'm going to see what happens when I finish edit mode. It says it's not a closed loop. Continue. I need to use trim to close these two parts. Now it should be good. There is one more gap here. Okay. So we're going to work on this area. First, I would like to have a little bit of slope going away from the building. So when you work on the sidewalk, you do not necessarily feel the slope, but there is usually a little bit of slope going away from the building. So the water is going to a little bit of pathway over there. I'm gonna use the same method that we can use for the roofs, which is modify subelements. I can go to level. For every 1 meter, or 100 centimeters, we're gonna have 2% or 2 centimeters of lowered elevation on those points. So for 3 meters, it's gonna be 6 centimeters. So I wanna grab those lines, that one, that line, and that one. And I want to, let's make sure that this is not selected. From there, that corner, all the way to this corner, the elevation is going to be negative 6 centimeters and the unit is set to meters, so I can go with negative 0.06. Okay, and let's see, if I go to modify subelements, click here, that's good. That's good. So if that's my zero, these are going to be 6 centimeters lower. Let's take a look here. It all seems good. So far so good. Next thing I want to do is that I want to work on this entrance, and I want to have maybe a different design here for the pavement. I can go here, click on this floor, edit boundary. I want to actually use join. So these lines could continue over there, and I want to split here and here. I want to delete this part and trim that line, that line, that line, and that line. Okay, I can also delete this one. So for this part, I would like to have a different floor, right? It might not accept the shape that we have because it's not one closed loops, it's two closed loops, but we're gonna see. Yeah, okay. Oh, okay, it created the floor. Very good. Now I would like to use a different method to create the floor over there. I'm gonna go to floor, architectural, and I can get these walls. I can pick this line, and I would like to go with trim. Okay, this seems good. Now I want to work on different design for this part of the floor. I want to select this floor. Actually, how about I go to edit type, duplicate. I want to change some things here. Let's say we're gonna have one layer at the top. I'm gonna change the thickness here to 0.3, and this one is gonna be 0.1 or 10 centimeters, and we're gonna have a different material here. You can also change the rest of the floor to the type that we created. For this part of the floor, I want to go to create parts. You already know about create parts. Now I want to select the part at the top, and we want to work with divide parts. Okay, so this part is something new. Let's go to divide parts. I'm gonna go to level 1. Now you can draw very different patterns here. You can assign different materials to part of the pattern that you create here. Feel free to first set your plane. How about I go to architecture, set, pick a plane. This is gonna be my plane. Now I'm gonna start sketching, edit sketch. Now that we selected the work plane, I can draw the pattern here. Let's start by like a circle. How about I go with like 1 meter for the radius? Then I would like to copy this circle a few times. You can move them using arrow keys. Maybe I don't need the last one. I also want to copy them in the other direction. I want to move this to the center. And I want to close this. If I go to my other view, you see that now in the floor we have different parts here, and we can actually assign different materials to them. I'm going to show you how we can work with the materials on this floor in the next video.